I need your assistance figuring out train furnace error codes.
The flashing on a train furnace doesn't necessarily mean something is wrong. A slow flash means it is running as normal without a call for heat, while a fast flash means it is heating things up.
And a continuously on light means the control panel needs to be replaced.
You can try power cycling the furnace by turning it off at the breaker and back on.
That is the same thing I do if the gaming console gets locked up and never flashes or changes the screen.
If the furnace light was always off, you'd want to check the breaker anyway, since the unit has no power.
I put that in the category of course you would check that.
If the train furnace flashes twice, that means it has a system lockout due to a lack of flame or reversed polarity.
How do you get reversed polarity on a furnace?
Someone miswires it.
Then that error code is a lockout because the flame is out. And I need to clean the pilot tube or check for humidity in the unit.
It could give you a two-flash error code because the flame sensor is dirty or the thermocouple is too far from the flame too. Three flashes, though, is the pressure switch.
If the drain tubes are full of moisture or obstructed with dirt, that can trip the pressure switch too.
Cleaning the furnace is cheaper than replacing components too. Four flashes means the thermal limit protection is off.
I'm calling for a repairman in that case. I'd rather the repairs burn a hole in my wallet than risk burning down the house.
Five flashes means flame is sensed with a gas valve off.
I've heard of flames not getting recognized because the flame is weak because of humidity or dirt or low airflow. How do you get a flame without gas?
A gas valve that isn't closing as fast as it should or stuck open.
Or a malfunctioning sensor.
That's actually rather rare, since it is hard to fake heat but easy to mistake something warm for cold.
That's not making me feel warm and fuzzy about these error codes.
Train furnaces have problems with inadequate covers on the air intake pulling in leaves, tripping the pressure switches.
That I can easily clean up and correct, assuming a leaf on fire isn't why the furnace senses a flame though the gas valve is closed.
I'd feel less bad about calling a repair person to clean that up than hit the reset button for me at $200 an hour.